My name is Michael Wüttrich. I'm a senior lecturer here at Zurich University of Applied Sciences. We're located in Winterthur, close to Zurich, Switzerland. The students, they really like 3D printing. A lot of students that come here have an own 3D printer at home, but the other ones, they really like that you're able to have this fast prototyping possibility, to have a feedback if everything works, if the parts fit together and all this. And they also like how easy it is to use to get from the CAD model to the printed part. But one thing I have to tell them, sometimes it's too easy. So I have to teach them to think before printing, and not just print and try and reprint and retry and reprint and retry, but first think, then print, and then it should work, yeah. For example, last year I gave them the task to build a robot which is able to climb a stair. And so they make different concepts on the paper, then they make a CAD drawing, and then they print it. And they really made very nice robots, which all were able finally to climb up the stairs. What we also do in our group is we try to develop way how you slice, how you print, and all these things. And what we did is we just tried to get rid of the support material, because I think it's a waste of material, it's a waste of time. So we were looking for a way to be able to print 90 degrees overhangs without support material, and we made a new print head which we attached to a Prusa Mark III printer, which has an additional rotational axis and which now is able to print 90 degrees overhangs without any support material. Right now we're working on another system, how to be able to print without support material on a normal Prusa printer, just with a very slight improvement, which I don't want to talk too much about, but which, if it really works and it looks good, which would be a really improvement, because you don't need the support material anymore. The development of the four-axis printer you find on Printables. It's open source. We don't have the time to have a fancy documentation about it, so you need some engineering skills. But still, if you have them, you can download all the files, all the bill of material, and everything you need to rebuild this four-axis printer. Yeah. We decided to buy the original Prusa printers because also of my personal experience with other printers which didn't really work, which haven't really been reliable. And with this Prusa printers we have in our lab here now, we never have problems, they just worked. If something is misaligned, for example the Z axis, then it's very easy to recalibrate it, and then it's working again. So we're very happy with our decision for this printers, and for sure we will, within a short time, we will buy some new printers to have more printers for the students.